Possessions come and go. Some stay longer than others. Some we would guard with our very lives, and others we would hardly at all notice if they disappeared completely. One possession in particular vanishes without our noticing because it is just as quickly replaced by an identical replica. Infinite in form, but finite in perception, this most valuable of all possible possessions is time. We all own this in different quantities, but some let what they are given slip away without even noticing. What I hope to shed light on is how we might go about making the most of this precious, finite resource gifted by chance or by grace. 1.8. This number represents the amount of human beings who die each second, some on their first year and others on their 100th. Because of this uncertainty, we must make use of the time we have, for it can be taken without notice. Often the days seem long, but the years short. When speaking to the older generations, you may hear them say that as you get older, time seems to speed up. I've often wondered why this might be. Well, surely how we store memory plays an extensive role, but I believe there's something more. When we are young, all experience is new, and we look to the universe with an awe that seemingly dissipates as we age, causing knowledge that was previously flavorful to go bland. This cessation of new experience makes the days blend, sort of how the 8 in this picture can hardly be distinguished among the sea of bees. How might we go about combating this? Well, the answer is simple. You must continue learning new information, seeing new places, and experiencing new cultures. While going about this, you must also keep your mind and eyes open to learning new information. Otherwise, any new information will simply overflow like water that is poured into a full glass, leaving you with nothing new, only a life of indistinguishable days. We must also take heed of the past, that of your own and that of others. As said by Seneca, he makes his life long by combining all times into one. The wonderful thing about philosophy is that the great men and women of the past have laid out their experience and knowledge so that we can apply it, if we so desire, to our own lives. I also recommend scheduling out your day. Have a set plan and routine. This way you minimize the time spent in discursiveness. Our schedule can and often does become hectic. When this happens, it is easy to become overwhelmed and get lost in procrastination, trying to find out where to even begin. This postponement, as said by Seneca, is the greatest waste of life. It deprives you of each day as it comes. It snatches from you the present by promising something hereafter. Control your day. Don't let it control you. Begin fully appreciating the time that you do have right now, because one thing is certain, that for us finite beings, time has a beginning and an end. Most of the time, we have no way of knowing when this end is to come. So in this case, just as a wild animal eats everything they are able because the next meal is uncertain, we should use all the time that we are given to its fullest. Let me leave you with another quote from the eloquent writings of Seneca. Life will follow the path it started upon, and will neither reverse nor check its course. It will make no noise, it will not remind you of its swiftness. Silent, it will glide on. It will not prolong itself at the command of a king or at the applause of the populace. Just as it started on its first day, so it will run. Nowhere will it turn aside, nowhere will it delay. I hope this video has given you something to think about in the new year. If you liked the video and would like to see more like it, make sure you subscribe to the channel. As always, until next time, thanks for talking philosophy with me.